See, we are going to study the identification test for the gas carbon dioxide. For this, we'll be needing all this, right? So what we have here, first we have the calcium hydroxide, that is the slaked lime, we are pouring in a test tube, as you can see, right? So, but just to show the reaction, we first need the carbon dioxide. So that means we are in immediate need of carbon dioxide. So what we are doing, we are adding calcium carbonate into it and we are mixing with the dilute HCl, because calcium carbonate, when reacts with HCl, it liberates the carbon dioxide gas. So carbon dioxide, when they will react with each other, they will just liberate the carbon dioxide gas. We are fixing the funnel so that we can get out the carbon dioxide gas. And where we are going to just supply this carbon dioxide gas, we are going to supply in a test tube which carries the slaked lime. So we are just the reaction is occurring, and you know that CO2 is being produced, CO2 is just passing, and with the passage of time, what we get to see, that the transparent color of calcium hydroxide is just turning milky, right? So this is, you can say, the one of the test which shows that when carbon dioxide gas is passed through lime water, it turns lime water milky. So this is the one of the test. So we have one more test. We are just lighting the splinter, and we are just like bringing the splinter and putting in that beaker which contains the carbon dioxide. We get it blows off, because carbon dioxide gas is non-supporter of combustion. Now what we are doing, we are adding water to this solution. We have the carbonic acid, and we are just using the litmus paper. As you can see that with the passage of time, litmus is just turning red in color. You know why it is turning red? It is turning red because this has the carbon dioxide. When you add water to it, water plus carbon dioxide give rise to a weak acid, that is the carbonic acid. And what the effect of acid is on the blue litmus? It turns the blue litmus red. As you can see, the whole blue litmus just turns red. So what are the identification tests actually which we can do for carbon dioxide? We are just summing up. That is, we know that it is a colorless gas, because you don't get to see any kind of colored fumes rising up, right? So it is a colorless gas. And if you talk about the smell, it is odorless. We cannot feel any kind of suffocating, pungent or a pleasant smell, no kind of smell. So it is odorless. And when we just concerned with the test, what it does actually, it turns the moist blue litmus paper red, because you can say, because it give rise to the weak acid, that is the carbonic acid. So carbonic acid, you know that the acids turn blue litmus red, so it has the same effect. And moreover, it turns lime water milky. And one more thing, you know that where the carbon dioxide is used actually, it is, you can say, we have the fire extinguishers installed in our buildings and all, right? So what happens, they just work when there is any kind of fire in the building. So what happens actually in that, you can say, the fire extinguisher, there is a sulfuric acid and there is a baking soda present. So when they just react, when the knob is pressed, they just react with each other and they liberate CO2. And you know how CO2 just extinguish fire? It is non-supporter of combustion. As you saw, it just blows off that burning splint, right? Because it forms a protective layer, it cuts off the oxygen supply, and hence it extinguish fire. So it is also one of the property that the it is a non-supporter of combustion. It is the property of the carbon dioxide. So we can just identify the carbon dioxide by looking at either of the property, right? So that is the lime water milky. The other one is it is non-supporter of combustion. It extinguishes the the lighted splinter, and moreover it turns the lime water milky. So this is the test actually which identify the carbon dioxide gas.